things unused. All right, everybody, we are back to get into some news, so check it out. I know we haven't jumped around to that market cap lately because things are looking pretty good, but we're gonna jump to it today and we're gonna say, look, man, the market cap to drop from 2.9 down to 2.6, bro. What's going on? I know what is going on is, yeah, it dropped a little bit. You know what I'm saying? It's going to bounce back. You know, it's going to bounce back. So check this out. $740 million got liquidated in the last 24 hours. You see that there? $740 million got liquidated. All right. So why is it that $740 million got liquidated? I don't know. Let's see. In a market wrap, cryptocurrency sell-off stabilizes amid the U.S. tax concerns. So what happened? Well, there was a sell-off, right? Liquidation happened because people got scared by this new tax plan. Everybody's scared, like, they're coming for our crypto. We're going to pay buku tax. You're going to pay taxes. That's inevitable. You're going to pay taxes. If that's got you scared and you're selling off, look, how many people are in the stock market? You know you pay taxes on that too, right? How many people got 401ks? Yeah, when you withdraw that money, what happens? You pay taxes on that too. So there's nothing new there. All right, so those are possibly a few reasons why we've seen a sell-off and liquidation. And also people are scared and want cash in their hands with all the other things going on. And this could be related easily to quote unquote COVID crisis and everything else. People are scared of the trade agreements, as if we're gonna have trade disagreements for real. We're not gonna have, come on now. China, we're working with China. So let's not act. All that stuff you see on TV is, don't believe the hype. All right, NBA team Houston Rockets to integrate Bitcoin services to be paid in Bitcoin. Yes, they want that Bitcoin, all right? Major moves for adoption. Polygon launches a ZK stock scaling solution for dApp deployment. Okay, so Polygon's trying to make it easy for applications to be made and cheaper for people to have these applications up and running to make things profitable, because we know Ethereum is expensive, but Polygon being a second layer, it's doing things. Okay, so that's good news. Bitcoin company Synonym launches architecture for a self-sovereign economy. Now listen to this. They're trying to they're trying to shut the dollar out. I told y'all that it's going to happen. The dollar, the way you know the dollar is going to change, you'll probably still see the dollar in the fact that this will equate to the value of, but you probably will no longer see the dollar coming here in the future. You won't see it anymore. U.S. Justice Department is selling $56 million in crypto to compensate victims of BitConnex fraud. So first and foremost, the United States got crypto. This is not nothing new. So if you think that they're going to get rid of it, no. They're going to keep it and they're going to tax it because this is the new economy. But hey, you don't need me to tell you that. We got these articles to show you. Ripple outlines possible regulatory framework for crypto industry in the United States. So the reason why we look at Ripple Network being in that lawsuit with the SEC is because they're working together to figure out the best way to approach the crypto situation. So taxes and everything else with cryptos and how to catch people evading and so all these things, Ripple is actually in their pocket working with them. So hey man, Ripple said that way back when. They said we're gonna do whatever it takes to work with the United States government. It is what it is. So there's no secrets there. Expect more to come out of that. Peru's central bank is developing a central bank digital currency. That's self-explanatory. All nations are gonna have their own central bank digital currency, in which case you can cash out of your cryptos to their native currency if you want to what? Do business with their native currency. Okay, no shocker there. We knew that was coming. Blueprint for CFTC regime over crypto exchanges enters Congress, right? So the Commodity Funds Trading Commission draft bill would establish a new regulatory regime for cryptocurrency exchanges at the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. Currently, spot markets have no federal regulator in the U.S., though that is a contentious subject. However, the CFTC does not generally have a regulatory regime with expectations for executions and reporting for spot commodities markets. In spot markets, it is typically limited to enforcement against fraud and manipulation. So we already heard, it was, as I said last week, that they were going to be basically setting up who's going to be watching what and making laws and decisions and everything else. So clearly we see here they're taking their position on what's going to be happening in the future. Let's see what else. Israel's new anti-money laundering rules may help banks onboard crypto clients. Okay, again, all nations are in the crypto space. Cryptos will stop money laundering, so just imagine what banks are going to be doing next. Ted Cruz aims to repeal crypto broker rules from Biden's infrastructure bill. All right, Ted Cruz, you do what you think you can get done. I hope the best for you, but the United States is not Biden, okay? What's going on has nothing to do with Biden. He's just a puppet, and he's talking and doing what he's told to do, and you're not going to stop the United States. So what else do we got? All right, I'm gonna close with this. It says Staples Center will be renamed crypto.com arena. New logo will debut on Christmas Day. Let that be something to sink into your brains. That's major news as far as the crypto space and adoption. They're changing the name of the Staples Center. All right, that's what I got. If you like the video, hit that like button. Please subscribe to the channel and also hit that bell for notifications so you'll know when I drop another video and you can check it out.